the OSCE head of mission, Ambassador Jonathan Moore, emphasized yesterday in his keynote address, the OSCE mission to BIH strives to identify critical challenges in the processing of war crimes cases in BIH and try to develop some potential solutions to overcome certain issues that we observe. Our mandate and our institutional memory span 20 years since when, under the Dayton Accords, the OSCE mission began its work as one of the primary actors working on seeing justice and peace implemented in the country. Currently, we focus much of our work in seeing through the completion of the country's plan to deliver justice to the victims of genocide, crimes against humanity, and war crimes. We do this first by monitoring the country's progress in processing war crimes cases in accordance with both international standards and in line with the 2008 National War Crimes Strategy. This allows us to provide tailored advice and support to justice sector actors in their efforts to combat impunity for these crimes and seek justice for the victims. In addition, we also aim to promote transparency in the judicial process through certain tools such as our online case map and through periodic reports. I'll talk first about the findings of our monitoring program. Since Chief Prosecutor Salihovich already discussed some of the significant progress that his office has made in addressing genocide, crimes against humanity, and war crimes cases, my discussion will focus a little bit more on data on how the entity-level jurisdictions and on how the prosecutor's office and courts in BIH as a whole have progressed. So I know while justice for many wartime atrocities does oftentimes appear to be very slow, the OSCE mission has observed steady and encouraging progress in the past decade. We have monitored over 500 war crimes trials between 2004 and 2014. This includes at both the state and the entity level. And these cases dealt with around 800 accused individuals. During this 10-year period, approximately 300 cases against around 440 accused individuals have been completed. There have been around 350 individuals convicted of various war crimes charges. And this includes in the context of 50 plea agreements. So that is close to an 80% conviction rate. 40 of these convictions occurred in the year 2014 alone. At the same time, a number of indictments filed in war crimes cases nearly doubled between 2013 and 2014, with almost 100 indictments confirmed against around 170 accused last year. I should just note, this is not official data from the public institutions. Again, this is just from our trial monitoring program. Since 2008, the OSCE mission has aligned its monitoring framework with the National War Crimes Strategy. And this strategy seeks to provide, to guide the reduction in the reduction of the investigations backlog by providing a system of prioritization and allocation between the state and entity level jurisdictions. Over the past several years, the mission has observed the increasing transfer of less complex cases from the state court to the entity and Birchgo district's courts, and this is envisaged by the strategy. A total of 318 cases were transferred since the beginning of 2012 to the end of 2014. And the state court has actively taken over 116 of these cases over that same three-year period. The entity and Birchgo district prosecutors and courts have made significant progress over the last year in reducing their investigation backlogs. And this has been supported by supplemental EU budgetary support, which has allowed for the necessary, for various necessary resources and the hiring of additional staff. During the year 2014, the mission observed the completion of 21 trials at entity courts that ended in final verdicts. At the end of 2014, there were 115 trials ongoing in entity and Birchko district courts. And of course, there were many more indictments confirmed and awaiting the setting of trial dates. I should note also that about one in six of these cases involves an allegation of wartime sexual violence, indicating a significant effort to address these especially sensitive cases. The trends that we've observed do signal a genuine commitment on the part of the justice sector to resolve the backlog of war crimes cases, and also reflects a sustained support from partner organizations and governments, notably the European Union and the ICTY, which have bolstered the process by providing necessary staff and resources and training in order to tackle these cases. In spite of the successes we have observed, there are, much remains to be addressed in order to ultimately secure justice for the country. Around 1,000 investigations with known suspects are still waiting to be processed. Many allegations of war crimes with unknown perpetrators must also be addressed. Aside from the mission's extensive monitoring efforts, through our analysis, we've been able to identify some specific challenges in the process and make some targeted recommendations as to how they might be approached. In certain thematic reports, we've provided some observations that illustrate some significant challenges and obstacles to implementing the National War Crimes Strategy. Several of these obstacles, some of these challenges, have already been addressed by a number of speakers, so I'll just address a few in order to save time. Securing witness testimony does remain a challenge, particularly at the entity level, where witness support and witness protection is not at the same level as with the state jurisdictions. Yet, as has been repeatedly emphasized, the testimony of these witnesses is essential. There's been some notable progress in providing necessary support for witnesses, for survivors who are brave enough to testify. And this really is due to a number of very talented and dedicated men and women from Bosnia and Herzegovina who work in the psychosocial fields and have had the opportunity to lend their services to the process thanks to a number of internationally donor-funded projects. Other challenges include the need for greater regional cooperation, a number of successes and steps in the right direction have occurred, and these were noted by the prosecutors to my left. But I think we can all agree that further implementation is needed. There have been some challenges in ensuring the prioritization of some of the most complex cases. This is a requirement of the National War Crimes Strategy. The OSCE Mission has worked with the prosecutor's office throughout BIH in order to help streamline the process of prioritizing war crimes cases. For example, through assisting in the development of the individual action plans for the processing of cases. A final challenge I'll mention is that while the resources and capacity continue to increase in BIH to process these cases and to further tackle the war crimes backlog, it's challenging yet essential to ensure that an overall high quality of the proceedings. And this is why it's essential that professionals working on these cases continue to receive adequate training, supervision, and monitoring. The OSCE Mission has trained hundreds of professionals working on war crimes cases over the past year. We've had the very strong support of the ICTY and the EU in that process.